If you drive in South Florida, dealing with gridlock and traffic is an everyday occurrence, and the problem only seems to be getting worse. To help alleviate the problem, county officials in Miami-Dade are focused on implementing a new smart plan for mass transit. County Commission Chair and head of the Transportation and Public Works Committee, Esteban Bovo, joins us with the very latest on what's being done. But first, we visit a major transit hub, downtown's Government Center, to get your take on things.
You made a huge tunnel to the port. Hardly anybody uses it. Billions of dollars that could have gone to getting bigger, better buses, more handicapped accessible buses, because with this machine, I cannot get on either the big buses or the new ones, the two-part buses.
The tolls are horrible. Like 10 bucks, I think, for the express lanes. They're charging more every year, and they're putting more tolls. So it's ridiculous, to be honest. I'd suggest to lower their tolls or put less tolls so people can actually get around without having to pay, 30, 40 bucks a day to get to work and to come back home.
Well, I think traffic in Miami is improving as a result of some of the transportation initiatives that have happened. And I do think that it's going to get even better once the construction and infrastructure is finished. Downtown, Brickell, Coral Gables, Coconut Grove. And it seems to me that there's a core transportation there that is effective. It doesn't seem to me that when you go to the outer bounds, it's as effective as it should be or it could be.
And joining me now to address your transit concerns and potential solutions is Miami-Dade County Commission Chairman Esteban Bovo. Thank you so much for joining us, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you.
So you heard a lot of concerns there from people, probably things you have already heard before. Let's face it, if you live in Miami-Dade County, no matter who you are or what you do, you're affected by transit. So folks are looking for solutions to their problems. What is the county doing to help alleviate some of the things that we heard from some of those folks?
First and foremost, those are valid concerns, and I get a lot of them either via Twitter or email. I get a lot of communications from those that use our transit system. So I get it. I understand it. Yeah. I live in Miami-Dade County. I'm stuck in the same traffic patterns. I also use our metro rail to get to the county government and realize its deficiencies. Miami-Dade County now is experiencing what I would categorize as about maybe 30 years or 40 years of poor planning. Miami-Dade County grew in an explosive, rapid way in the 60s, which created neighborhoods that is the classic definition of urban sprawl. We connected those neighborhoods via roads. That's okay when your county's 500,000, 600,000 people. But when your county morphs to 2.7 million, when your county probably has an additional million in town, either on vacation or for work, now it becomes catastrophic. Our bus system doesn't work because it's in the traffic pattern. So why take a bus that'll take you 3 hours when your ride could take an hour? Therefore, county officials, collectively with state, federal partners, and other municipal leaders, have all come together and realized we can't sustain the financial viability of Miami-Dade County, its potential moving forward, if we don't address this issue now in a very aggressive manner. Therefore, the smart plan. And the smart plan really tries to address all corridors in Miami-Dade County. What is still in doubt, and which quite honestly has been the product of a lot of debate and conversations, what kind of technology do you roll out?
Yeah.
Do you do rail? Do you rely on the transit issues, for example, autonomous vehicles and whatnot? And that becomes the question mark. And quite honestly, that's why we haven't moved forward
yet. So let's talk specifically about the SMART plan, which stands for Strategic Miami Area Rapid Transit Plan.
Government does that a lot.
Yeah. So because if you're at home, you're saying SMART plan, what is that? It's a SMART plan? No, mm-hmm. It's an acronym for something here.
Sure.
So we're talking about light rail buses. What is that exactly? What is light rail? Is that metro rail or is that rails that run down a street or like where the bus lane is in South Miami-Dade County? What is that exactly?
A couple of things to be clear on. The SMART plan's goal and mission is to fulfill the promise that the People's Transportation Plan made. The voters in Miami-Dade County were asked to opine back in, I believe it was 2002. We were asked to opine on an issue to levy an additional half penny toward transit. At that time, the charrette, the campaign, spoke about a massive expansion of Metro Rail, which never happened, quite honestly. There's been some incremental expansions, but about 2 miles over that period of 15 years. The Smart Plan now tries to fulfill that promise. I feel obligated, not promises that I made, but I feel obligated that we need to fulfill this vision of how do we connect our community under a couple of caveats. One is I wanted to produce development, produce jobs and economic opportunity. You're not going to build rail to nowhere. You need to build and have connectivity. This has happened, by the way, in countries all over the world, if not, and also in the United States, where we've seen mass transit be a linkage to transit-oriented development. Like I said, brings jobs, economic opportunities, and creates hubs throughout the county of activity. We see some of that already. Dadeland is a product of transit. You have two Metro Rail stations there, and we've seen the explosion on the west side of the rail line on how much we've seen. It's clear at this point, though, that we're not going to see any more expansion of Metro Rail. At literally $100 million a mile, we could probably put that away at this point. So when we talk about light rail, we're talking about Metro light rail system at grade, basically on the ground level. Okay. Again, other communities have done this around the country, around the world, and it's something that's ripe for Miami-Dade County.
Yeah. Well, I'm going to read a quote to you. You have been quoted as saying, and we're talking the money here, unless the county secures a sustainable funding mechanism, there are no corridors. All corridors, the sixth one that we are talking about, are important and must be completed, but without funding, all we can do is continue talking about them. So we're talking, Mr. Chairman.
Yes.
So where do we get the money for that? We mentioned that halfpenny sales tax that we all had agreed upon and voted for back in 2002. We've talked about there's federal funds, state funds, and local tax money. How do we put all that together and get what we need? Because we do need it here in the county. We can't keep talking about it.
Absolutely. And part of our mission for the most part of the last year and a half, 2 years, has been identifying funding sources. So here's what we've been able to identify. We believe that the PTP money, as of 2023, projected for 30 years, will be able to spill out about $1 billion in revenue. This is tax dollars, sales tax money, that we've already levied and have the opportunity now to be able to draw out at $30 million a year with bonding capacity. We could start seeing a pattern of growth as far as money is concerned. That local dollar is eligible for state matching dollars. And one of the things that we'll be doing over the next couple of months is talking to our stakeholders at the state, who, by the way, have been very supportive of the Smart Plan and have actually helped us with one of the east-west corridors as far as a nexus with MDX and ability to use MDX money, toll money, to be able to develop an east-west corridor. What we hope to do is, in essence, take the six lanes of the Smart Plan, one of them, which is, in essence, the north and the south end, which are have Metro Rail in the middle. The south end is the busway corridor that we all know. It's already a dedicated corridor for transit. In the north, we'd have to buy some right-of-way to be able to do a corridor. Our thoughts, our idea is to take that corridor, that north-south corridor, and take it to the federal government and look for and be eligible for funding from the federal end. So you would do it with local money, state money, federal money. Now, you may ask me, what about the other corridors? And the other corridors is, one, you'd have the MDX 836 cut through, which basically one of the complaints about tolls is that MDX, not the county, is the one that operates that road. We believe, and we've already instructed through the TPO, which is our planning organization for transit, the Transit Planning Organization, the TPO, 13 commissioners, various city officials sit on it. We've already instructed MDX to help fund and develop the corridor at East West, which would be basically from the airport all the way out to 137th Avenue. On the beach corridor and on the northeast corridor, we believe we have partners at the private end. We also have a partnership with Miami Beach where we could create perhaps an extension of the Metro Mover, which is in downtown Miami, out to the beach. Northeast, we have Brightline, which has already developed a station downtown, and we believe, and all it takes really is an interlocal agreement with them for either they or we provide service along the rail line, which would take us from downtown to Aventura. Now, the last corridor is the Kendall Corridor, and that would basically has a nexus with the Turnpike. same conversation we've had with MDX, we want to have it with a turnpike, where perhaps some of that turnpike toll money can be used for us to be able to develop these corridors. But Pam, I will tell you, the challenge is not only is acquiring the corridors and the right-of-way. That's a challenge, and it's a money challenge. The challenge then comes, what do you put on there? Do you put bus? Do you put rail? And what kind of technology? And that's a debate that we're having in County Hall. I'm a believer that rail helps me bring that development. Rail is more stable, is more predictable. But I will concede that in the future, technology will evolve in a way where train-like buses can also be deployed in some of these corridors. But the goal is to give folks alternatives. We know we're not going to change your driving habits. Right. They're set in stone for many, many years. But your children may move differently. I know mine are going to move differently. And that's where other components come in, like Uber and Lyft and other ways of moving.
We're all moving around in different ways, aren't
we?
But it's going to take time, because we even saw just even building the latest construction with MDX where through the Palmetto Expressway, that whole corridor there, it took a long time. So,
but if people see movement, and I think that's one of the demands, one of the frustrations I think you're hearing in folks is that they want to see action. They don't want to see us talk about this anymore.
I'm quite honestly done
with the talking. I'd like us to take a move now.
We have run out of time. There's so much more to talk about. We haven't even hit the rest of your agenda. So
I
we'll
told
have
you
to
this
have
was
you
gonna
back.
Happen.
Yeah, I know, right? Thank you so much for being here today. We really appreciate it.
My pleasure.
And if you have a comment about Miami-Dade or South Florida Transit or any issue impacting your community, we want to hear from you. Send us your take. You can reach us on Facebook and Twitter at YourSouthFL. Send us a video or leave us a comment. We look forward to hearing from you.